George McBarron, and welcome to Tuba Talk, where we talk about A, pickles, C, the bomb squad, or D, tubas. If you guessed pickles, you're wrong. If you guessed the bomb squad, you're right. Wait. Oh, sorry. I mean, you're wrong.
Boo.
If you guess tubas, you're right. Today, we'll be interviewing some random person who likes tubas.
I know that guy.
And as an added bonus, I'm wearing a weird looking hat called a fez that doesn't fit me.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Hi. I'm so glad to be here.
Hi.
Hi. I'm a random tuba enthusiast. I'm so glad I answered that ad on Craigslist.
Okay, first question. What type of tuba do you have?
Oh, man. I knew this was coming. I don't actually have a tuba.
Then you're gonna like what's in the gift basket.
Oh, boy, my mom told me to never give up, to always have faith that someday I would get my own tuba. Thank you, Fez guy and Fez hat. Any questions? I might as well do my job now that I'm gonna get, hopefully, a gift bag with an actual tuba in it. That's gonna be a big bag. Because we all know the tuba is a very big instrument.
Hey, we can manage. One day in the gift basket, we gave out elephants.
That must have been a good show.
Okay. Well, if you're such a tuba expert, then what family does the tuba belong to?
Easy. The tuba belongs to the brass family, along with the much less incredible trumpet and the far less perfect trombone.
So you're saying that the tuba is just the new improved version of the trumpet and trombone?
No, of course not. An instrument that is so perfect in every way could never be modeled after such tragic mishaps in the instrument world. Although different sources disagree over, you know, who's really responsible, because everybody wants to take credit for the tuba. It's so fantastic. I believe that the history of the tuba all goes back to a fantastical instrument called the serpent. Ooh, I brought a picture.
Dun, dun, dun.
This is the serpent. It is a horrible, magnificent looking thing. The serpent was invented in France by Edmond Guillaume around 1590. The original serpent coiled back and forth like a snake, had six holes instead of keys, and was actually made of wood covered in leather, completely unlike the modern metal tuba.
Oh, God. Okay. What tuba is made out of?
The most common type of metal used for tubas today is yellow brass, which is a 70-30 blend of copper and zinc.
Okay, who invented the tuba?
Well, the modern valve tuba was invented by Adolf Sachs. He was trying desperately but successfully to make up for having invented the far more inferior saxophone. Right, the dread saxophone. Whew, always stealing the spotlight. The first tuba, however, was invented by Wilhelm Weiprecht and Johann Gottfried Moritz. Pretty interesting.
Ooh. How does a tuba make sound?
Sit down in front of
it. How does a tuba make sound?
First, the tubist would buzz his or her lips. Let's all try that. Go ahead, try that at home. Then the sound waves bounce around, echoing each time as they go around the coils. They bounce around.
Here's an example with my hands. First, this, and then. Sorry about that.
Yeah, thanks. I'll take the bruise and the gift bag.
Oh.
The resulting sound is much louder than it originally started out at the beginning part of the tuba.
When was the tuba's magical first appearance into the music world, and in what kind of ensemble? Hey kids, if you don't know what ensemble means, look it up.
Your audience isn't enthusiastic about that. The tuba was used in, you know, probably individually in various, like, orchestra settings, but it was first widely used in 1835 by British brass bands. Say that three times fast.
British brass band. Okay.
Tough, right?
So, what does the tuba sound like?
The tuba makes a deep sound that no other instrument can make. The pitch, however, depends on the type of tuba. There are different types of tuba that make sounds that are in different parts of that lower register where the tuba habits. Like, you know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of one of those prehistoric looking fish that's at the very bottom part of the ocean and nobody else goes down there and nobody else goes. I'm sorry, I'm getting a little distracted.
You ever find Finding Nemo? Okay. We want to hear a tuba today. What kind of music should we listen to?
A tuba is still used today because you could never discard such a fantastic instrument. Mostly you find tubas in symphonies and jazz ensembles. And anything that an orchestra plays. In fact, you're probably hearing a tuba and may not even know it. I bet everyone in the audience, I see you, knows a piece of tuba music without knowing it is a tuba. It is from a famous movie whose director said that the movie would not have been half as good without the music. This is where you say,
roll videotape! Is it wrong?
The name is Jaws Theme by John Williams, and the fabulous tuba parts are performed by Tommy Johnson. This short video shows the power and awesomeness of the tuba. I think we can all agree.
Woo!
Go tuba! Wow! That's impressive. That cat scared me like crazy, all because of the music.
Yes, it's actually very simple notes. It's very simple music, but it really does a lot, packs a lot of power. It's only E and F, and some people think it represents the shark's heartbeat. Dunna, dunna, dunna. You can bring whatever you want to your interpretation of what the music sounds like.
Interesting. Well, I guess that wraps it up. So, good night, everybody!
Thank you! Thanks for having me! Do I get my gift bag?
Here we go! Tuba! 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 Tuba!